Nick, if Kobe was hypothetically to miss the season, what kind of responsibility does that put on your shoulder?
It's a big responsibility. You know, I got to go out there and play, you know, to the best of my abilities every night. But it shows, you know. Last night, teams double team me every time I come off pick and roll. So obviously, I got to learn how teams are keen in. You know.
With the limited minutes last night, did you have a conversation with Byron today?
A little bit, but not that. You know, sometimes you got to, you know, just talk to him and go over certain things.
Coach mentioned that he didn't like your body language. Your thoughts on that at halftime?
You know, he's the coach. You know, and he's seen what he's seen. So, you know, it's not my place to get into that, really.
Could have been a mistaken of you being serious. You know, coach has talked about how you conduct yourself when things aren't going well. Yeah. Could it have been your more serious approach and as opposed to, you know, your usual jovial self?
Yeah, and you know, a lot to do with, you know, just frustration building up from losing. You know, obviously we only won 12 games this year. And losing could catch up to you, you know. And I'm still, you know, a human being. You know, I'm still going out there trying to fight. But you know, at the same time, you know, you get tired of getting beat up, and you just, you know, it could catch up to you.
How hard was it to sit there on the bench and not be able to get in the second half?
Oh man, it was very frustrating. You know, just brought back some old memories, like being a rook. You know, so but it happens. You know. You know, I guess he wants the best for me. You know, that's how, you know, I came in today with the mindset, you know, not having no negative energy, still trying to keep my upbeat self, so I'll be all right.
You think your ankle's fine enough for you?
Scott said that it almost looked like at times you didn't want to be there. Do you think that was misinterpretation, or is there a little bit of truth to it?
Oh, nah, you know, it ain't a day go by I don't want to be out there on the court, you know. Like I said, I love being here, love playing basketball. You know, I get a joy out of playing and seeing the fans and hearing them chant Swaggy P. So, you know, that's what drives me. But, you know, like I said, he's seen what he's seen. You know, I'm not in no situation to go back and forth with the coach because I would never play. So, hey, that's his judgment. You know?
What does it mean for this team to not have him?
You know, it's tough, you know, but we got to go out there and still fight, you know. Still got to give the fans a show. Still got to, you know, it's a chance for other people to step up now. It's a lot of players on this team in contract here. So, you know, even though it's tough for Kobe, you know, it's a blessing in disguise for other people to go out there and get a chance. So they just got to take full advantage of it.
Nick, we know it's speculation, but let's just say Kobe did not come back. What does the team collectively have to do to make up for such a big void from a technical standpoint?
Pretty much, just give me the ball and get out of the way.